I'm Alex, a data scientist from the Consumer Data Research Centre at the University of Leeds. In this video, I'll be talking about low carbon meals and how you can spot them, so you can look after the environment just through your food. Almost everything we do leaves a carbon footprint, from driving a car on the way to school, to cutting down trees to make the paper that we write on. Even the food that we eat has one. Carbon footprints measure the amount of greenhouse gases a process releases into the environment, leading to the huge issue that the world is facing of global warming and climate change. And across the world, our food accounts for over one third of the world's greenhouse gas emissions. Eating the actual food doesn't emit much, but the processes behind it do. Essentially, every step along the way adds to the carbon footprint, from the tractors to plant the seeds and harvest the crops, to the feed for the animals and the cows' digestive processes. Even that final step of processing the food, packaging it and transporting it has a carbon footprint. The more steps involved, the bigger the carbon footprint. So different foods have different carbon footprints. It's nearly impossible not to leave a footprint, but by changing what you eat, you can go from being a big foot to a little foot. Most fruits and veg have a lower carbon footprint. Processed foods like crisps and chips are a little bit bigger from the steps of slicing, processing and packaging the potatoes. Any animal product, like cheese, milk and sausages, have a much higher carbon footprint. Everything you can do to remove a step along the process is better, so eating local produce is often a good way to reduce your footprint. Now, when you make a meal, you add together all the different foods to have a carbon footprint for that meal. So, how can we make a low carbon meal? Let's take a shepherd's pie. Maybe you've got your beef and your mash. That's actually quite a high carbon footprint, as beef is a big contributor. But this is where we get to have some fun and try out some new things. If we add in some more veg, maybe even some beans or some lentils, we can lower the carbon footprint and still have a delicious beef and veg shepherd's pie. You can do it too. Remember, fresh and local produce is what helps make a low carbon meal. So let's plate up for the planet. What changes can you make to your dinner tonight?